This next material is bonus. It's optional, but it's really cool, and it will only take a few minutes to go through. So far, we've only used one predictor variable. In the case before, the predictor was the distance traveled, and we were using that to predict the flight cost. But oftentimes, there are many factors that can predict the dependent variable. When we use multiple predictors, we're doing multiple regression. The purpose is to explain more of the variation and why. Basically, we regress y on predictor 1, predictor 2, all the way to however many predictors we want. Why don't we just do a simple linear regression for each one? The reason we just have one equation is not only because it's easier, but also because when we include several predictors, we can calculate the relationship that each predictor has with y independently of the other predictors. For example, in my master's thesis, I wanted to look at things that impact student effort in math class. Remember that effort is a construct, so I measured this by things like whether or not they did their homework and time spent studying. A lot of things can influence effort. Specifically, I was interested in how much students value mathematics. Do they believe that math will help them in their careers? And also how much they enjoy math class and their relationship with their teachers. It's possible that having a good relationship with their teachers can make them enjoy school more. And if they enjoy school more, they'll put forth more effort. Or maybe students place value on subjects that they enjoy. When we include all of these as predictors, we no longer have a simple slope. Instead, we get regression coefficients for each predictor variable. These will be numbers, just like how before, when we had one variable, we found the slope, and that was our regression coefficient. In this case, we'll have three. These coefficients tell us the rate of change in y given a one-unit change in each respective variable, holding the others constant. In other words, we see the mathematical influence of one variable while statistically controlling for the influence of the other variables. We could go into more detail, but we won't. Multiple regression is not usually covered in elementary statistics courses, but it's still valuable to know about and be able to interpret. Apart from the regression coefficients, most programs that conduct multiple regression will also provide a multiple correlation coefficient called R. This is similar in interpretation to Pearson's R, but it involves one outcome or response variable and more than one predictor variable. This tells us the strength of the relationship between y and the combined set of predictors. Usually we're more interested in R squared, which tells us the proportion of variability in y explained by our set of predictors.